Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. If you want to get better at making bass lines, chords, melodies, this video is for you. So we're going to use my new plugin called Hercules at BusyWorksBeats.com/Hercules. We're going to start off in the bass and the dark side. So here's a bass line. So the question is, how do I know which notes to play? It's super, super simple once you understand the concept. It's called dominant to tonic relations. So for example, if you map out the C major scale, we're gonna go from C and it's all the white notes up until you reach C again. So here's C and it's all the white notes going up the keyboard until you hit C and then it repeats itself. So this is called the C major scale. In short, every major and minor scale has what's called a dominant note in the scale. It's the fifth of the scale. So this is the first note of the scale, second note, third note, fourth note, fifth note. So G and C like to resolve back to each other. And what I'm doing with the bass is I'm starting off at A. So this is called the relative minor. You don't need to memorize the terms I'm using. The point is, it's a concept. So we're going to take the fifth of the root note and then land there. So for example, we're gonna go to backwards from the root to the fifth. So we're gonna go A, E, that's the tonic to the fifth. So the easiest way to know this is a fifth is seven notes up from your root note. Okay, that's the easiest way to know this. So C, doesn't matter where you start, it's count up seven, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. It gives you what's called the perfect fifth. It always resolves to the perfect fifth and vice versa. They always harmonize, I should say. So what we can do is go from C, and if you don't know which note to play next, play G. But instead of going up an octave, like going upwards, I should say, we're gonna go down to G. So it's C to G, but we're, instead of going upwards, we're going downwards. And then we could also play octaves. Let me just play the bass. It's so much easier once you guys understand the fifths. Let's record this. So let's map this out into music theory and ease. So let's quantize this, hit Alt Q. A is moving to E. Why? Because E is the fifth of A. So A, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, you land on E. So A goes to E, that simple. And then we're using a half step to create tension here. You don't have to do that. It's just what sounded good for this specific bass line. And the question is, what note comes after F? Okay, so at the ending, you'll notice I create a change up. F goes to C. Now, if you pull it up an octave, F to C is seven notes away. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. They always resolve. So what I'm really playing is just a root note and then its fifth. A root note and then its fifth. And if you really want to get complicated, this is really an F major seventh chord played in different notes. So this is actually a chord spread out for those who are really into music theory. That's all you need to know is the fifth. So I can land on, I'm closing my eyes, you guys can't see, but I'm going to land on a random note. So that's C sharp. So I would go, okay, you count up seven notes from C sharp. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. That's going to give us G sharp. But again, instead of going up an octave, let's go down an octave. And those always sound harmonious. And the next is just what your ear hears. My ear hears what's called a half step. That's what creates that trap sound, as it's going from one note above to one note below, called a half step. And let's say I hit the half step note, but I don't know where to go. You count up seven notes from here. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Gives you E, so we're gonna do it again. And we're gonna land on E. And it always resolves. So let's do it again. We don't need to know what key we're in. You just need to know whatever note you're trying to move towards. Consider the note you're on, the root note, and ask which note is the fifth of this note. And you can either count up the keyboard 7 notes or down the keyboard 5 notes. So that's another shortcut. I don't want to confuse you guys with how many semitones away it is, but it's up 7 notes, it's down 5. So A to E is down 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So if you want to, and let's say I'm stuck here, I'm just going to count down 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Gives me E. I'm going to close my eyes again, land on a random note, just to keep proving to you guys that this works. So G, we're going to go to the fifth of G, which is D. I'm going to save you guys the time. Let's say I'm stuck on this note. D sharp, I don't know where to go. You just count down 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It gives me B flat. So would that start on G? And then you can always go back to the tonic to finish off any phrases. That simple. So bass is more simple than you guys probably understand. It's all about finding the fifth of whatever note you're playing, and then you could just keep resolving all the way back to the tonic. I know it sounds more complicated than what it actually is. If you struggle with music theory, just go to busyworksbeats.com/music theory. I'll help you guys over there. Peace out.